Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video we take a look at a set of milling cutters. These cutters are tungsten carbide and range from 12mm down to 2. We'll try the 6mm one and have a look at the cutting edge of a few of them under the microscope to see how they're sharpened. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. Here we have a set of carbide milling cutters from Banggood. The size range is from 12mm down to 2mm. If I take this 6mm cutter, we'll take a look at the end of the cutter. And you can't really see much at that distance, so I'll get the microscope out and we'll have a look under the microscope. Well, I've set the microscope up and put the 6mm N-mil cutter under the microscope. Now if we have a look at the cutting edge, you can see there that the cutting edge looks very sharp and precise. Let's move it round a bit. That's the cutting edge of the 6mm N-mil. Now we'll have a look at the cutting edge on the 3mm end mill to see if there's any difference in finish. Let's have a look at the cutting edge. That looks very good. So that was the 6mm and the 3mm we've seen. Now we'll have a look at the 12mm under the microscope. Now you can see there the finish is slightly rougher. I suppose they're using a bigger wheel. But the edges still look sharp. Just get that in focus. It's difficult with that size cutter. That's better. There's one of the cutting edges. Let's focus it up. You can see it's still got a sharp edge on there. Now we'll take the 6mm end mill, fit it in the collet. I'll make sure that the end mill goes right the way through to the back of the collet so it's fully supported. And we'll put that in the milling machine and see how the end mill performs on a piece of steel.
can hear a bit of vibration. It doesn't help that I'm ply milling. And I'll set the cutter speed at 1000 RPM.
That's a really good finish. I think the vibration is because I have it too far out of the vise. Let's just have a look at that. I've changed the material now. The previous one was steel, this one's aluminium. I'm slowly increasing the feed of the cutter. I'll add some WD-40 to stop the aluminium sticking to the cutter edge. Yeah, you can see there where I applied the lubricant, some WD-40. The finish is okay there, but there it's a lot smoother. Now obviously to test a set of cutters will take some time. I'll be using these cutters over the next few months, so we'll see how they perform in the long term.
Now you can see on the end where we use the WD-40, the finish is a lot smoother than where the milling cutter was just cutting dry. It's really difficult to show surface finish because what looks like a good finish in some situations looks like a poor finish in other lights. The only way to tell is to do a measurement on the finish.
There's a tool off the milling machine. I'll just give it a clean down and then we'll put it back under the microscope.
You can still see some bits of swarf on the tool, even though I thought it was clean. The edges still look okay. Well, that's the full set of cutters. I'll start with the biggest one, which is 12mm. Then we go down to 10, then 8, then 6, then 5, 4, 3, and 2. All of carbide steel. Each cutter is around £4, and I'll put a link on the beginning of the video data page. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful. Hope you enjoyed it. And we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.